we face the highly contagious COVID-19 virus, more people are turning to telemedicine. Joining us via Zoom from San Francisco is board-certified internal medicine physician and the chief medical officer of Doctor On Demand, Dr. Ian Tong. Dr. Ian, welcome. How is the COVID-19 pandemic changing how medicine is practiced?
Well, COVID-19 has really placed telemedicine squarely on the front lines of this battle. We're seeing our doctors do education for our patients, remote evaluations of those patients, and directing those patients to testing. We've actually seen over a 200% increase overall in our demand for visits on our practice. And we're actually seeing even government regulators begin to remove barriers like licensing requirements and allowing doctors to practice across state lines, which is really improving access.
Who should consider using telemedicine right now?
I really think just about everyone should, because we're seeing clinics being overwhelmed. Urgent cares and ERs are really functioning at capacity and overflowing. The other reason why patients should be using telemedicine is that you have patients who don't have COVID-19 going to sites of care, but those sites of care can actually become sites of transmission where they may actually get the virus themselves. The other thing that you're doing is if you have patients who are maybe mild to moderate symptoms with COVID-19 going to these sites of care, they may actually be making patients who are vulnerable, putting them at risk of catching COVID-19 and then becoming severely ill.
There's a common question that keeps coming up, which is that the symptoms of COVID are so similar to the common flu. So how can doctors tell the difference with telemedicine?
Yes, it can be difficult to differentiate between COVID-19 and flu. The truth is that's difficult to differentiate whether it's a telemedicine visit or whether that's an in-person visit. It's just there's so much overlap between the symptoms. So an important thing to remember here is that we are actually entering the end of flu season. So if someone is starting to develop flu-like symptoms this week or sometime in the next 2 weeks, it is probably much more likely that that infection is due to COVID-19. And so we're looking at those symptoms, we're going to evaluate them, and we're really asking our doctors to answer four simple questions. Does this patient have symptoms that require hospitalization or in-person care? Does this patient have flu-like symptoms that really increase our likelihood of flu, and should they be treated with Tamiflu? Does this patient require testing, and are there testing resources available? And then finally, we're asking, does this patient need to be isolated, and for how long do they need to be isolated? These major symptoms that we're looking at are fever, cough, usually it's a dry cough, sputum production, and then really respiratory difficulties. All of these are the most common symptoms, and those really apply with whether it's influenza or whether it's COVID-19.
So many Americans, speaking of testing, are frustrated that they aren't being tested. Even with COVID-19 symptoms, why isn't it necessary to test every patient?
One of the things that any doctor is going to think about before ordering a test for a patient is what's called the pre-test probability. So how likely is this patient to have this illness prior to the test? And will the test change my treatment? And so in this case, the answer is really, it's not going to make that much of a difference. If you think about a common urinary tract infection in a woman, that woman knows that she has a urinary tract infection if she's had one before. The doctor knows that she has that infection. So the test results really are not going to change what we're going to do in that case. And it's really the same with COVID-19. We have a high likelihood, a high suspicion because of the time of year. And so we're really going to be treating that just as we would if they had a test or not.
So you're going to be very aggressive with it. If somebody looks like they might have COVID-19, you are going to direct them to basically isolate and do whatever they can to stay away from other people so that they don't accidentally pass it on if it is indeed COVID.
That's absolutely right. So we would have that same recommendation. If you do have COVID-19 or you're suspected of having COVID-19, then we're going to actually ask you to act like you're infected or just assume that you are and then stay in isolation for 2 weeks.